Hello and welcome back to my tutorial series. Today we will be completing or starting and completing the AI blueprint. So let's jump right in. This episode is a voiceover because I had a lot of problems with recording this episode, so bear with me. Alright, so first what we want to do is add a component or two components. The first one, or both of them, being text renders. So let's add that. Let's bring it up to above the character on the left hand side and set the visibility to hidden. Then we can copy and paste that text render. We can grab it, set the visibility and pull it slightly over to the left. Remember to turn the visibility off. I didn't in the video, but you should. And set the text to HP. Compile. Let's head over to the event graph. And we're going to want to add an on component begin overlap on our box collision. And an on component end overlap. The other actor for our overlap will be us, so let's cast to my character. And then as my character, we'll pull off, and what we'll do is we'll set in battle to true. And then we're going to take our is in range variable and set that to true as well. Then we're going to want to drag off as my character and call our I'm in battle function. Then let's pull out our mesh and let's get world location. Then let's set our origin placement to world location. Moving on, let's copy and paste the cast to character and is in range, duplicate it, and connect it to the end overlap. And set is in range to off. Alright, what did I do next? We want to get an event tick. Or no, an event any damage. We need a way to damage our AI. So when we want to set our HP to our HP minus the incoming damage. Let's get a minus float and connect it up to the incoming damage and our set node. Then we're going to want to do an less than or equal to, or rather equal float, and equal to 0.0001. Then we need to make a branch, a condition being a 0001 node, and connect it to the event any damage. Off of our true node, or true execution pin, we're going to run a delay of 2 seconds. And off of our false node, we're going to bring in our mesh and play animation, which would be a hit reaction. And then we can connect that to minusing HP and then to our delay. We can drag off of our mesh then and set world location, connect the delay to that. We can again drag off of our mesh and say get forward vector or right vector forgot forward vector doesn't work for some reason, and do a vector times float and push it out 150 into the world. Do a plus vector, get our mesh's original location and put it in there, and then plug that into the new location. I was just cleaning up a bit there. Then we're going to play an animation. This would be his attack reaction. So he would be attacking us. Then we want to cast to my character and get the player character. And then we want to apply damage. And we want to apply damage to our character. I set the base damage to 0.1 for now. The damage causer would be self. And let's connect up that as my character to damaged actor. Right. Then we're going to get our mesh again. And say set animation mode to the in blueprint. We're going to pull off of our mesh once again and set world location. Plug that in next and set it to our original placement. You need to plug in the original placement. I didn't. Then we're going to run it a layer 1 second. Off of our character and say get battle widget, and we want to set the visibility. We're going to set it to visible because now we're in battle and we want to use our widget to attack. Then over on the event tick node, we're going to make a sequence, add a pin. Off of then one, we're going to do a branch, the condition being is our HP equal to or lower than 0. And then if it is, we're going to cast to my character and get the player character. And then as my character, we're going to get the battle widget reference and set the visibility to hidden. Connect that up. Then we need to pull off of my character again. Well, not just yet. Let's destroy the actor, this blueprint, the AI. And then we need to pull off of my character and get the battle widget end reference. And set its visibility to visible. Alright, then what do we do next? We're going to pull off our lane 1 and we're going to set our HP display. We're going to set it to our HP times 100. So let's get our HP and times it by a float. And that float to times it by will be 100. And let's connect that to the HP display. So it'll update the HP port of it to the power. Yeah.